Let's start by talking about charts and software. Do you understand tree charts and family group sheets and how best to use them? Should you use paper or a computer? Understanding the basics behind the charts and the family group sheets may help you to understand how best to use them going forward. In this video, we'll explain the background use and today's use for these charts and forms when we come back. Hi, I'm Connie Knox, a lifelong genealogist, and I'm here to help you go further, faster with your family research. So let's jump in. So let's talk about ancestral charts. Right from the start, you're going to want to visualize your family tree and understand how family groups are organized. For some of you, this may be basic, but understanding the charts and forms right from the beginning will be welcome information for the true beginner. Traditional genealogists, before computers, used several forms and formats to keep the families organized. Those same organizational ideas have carried forward to today in software and online trees. We're going to talk about ancestral charts, descendant charts, and family group sheets. The first two show you links between each generation, while the third shows each immediate family unit. By the way, I've produced links for free copies from the National Archives, FamilySearch.org, and Ancestry.com in the links below. First is the ancestral family tree chart. This chart starts with one person and shows the links between the parents, grandparents, great-grandparents, and so on in the direct ancestral line. The drawback to this chart is it doesn't show all of the children for each couple, but only each child in the direct lineage. Next is the descendants tree chart, and it starts with an ancestor and grows downward toward present day, and does show all of the children, at least all of the known children, of each couple. The drawback here is it's hard to show all of the descendants of one ancestor on one page. There really is no way to chart this on paper without taping multiple pages together, and quite frankly, I have taped these together and pinned them on my wall for easy reference, but computers are really easier. The family group sheet is not a tree at all, but a detailed sheet showing the father, the mother, and all of their children. Additionally, this group sheet shows birth, marriage, and death information with dates and places. You'll see similar layouts in various genealogy software and online programs. You'll want this information for each of your family groups. While all of these charts and forms have been replaced by software, it's good practice to have a few of these forms with you when visiting relatives and asking about family information. They help you show where the gaps are in your research, and the family will often help you fill in the holes they see are missing. Take multiple copies of the family group sheets with you, since you'll likely be talking about several family groups. You'll need one for each couple and their immediate family grouping. Alternatively, you can print out the same trees and family group sheets from your software and ask family to help fill in the gaps. When visiting family, I often bring my laptop and fill in the blanks right in the software as I'm talking with family. This saves a step, but as I always say, when working on computers, save early, save often, and cite your sources as you enter the information. Using genealogical software will save you a ton of time. You've got two good online sources with FamilySearch.org and Ancestry.com, or use software that is located on your computer. I use both. FamilySearch is a free service and is a public tree that anyone can modify. And at Ancestry, they have free and subscription options. It is your own family tree that only you and those you allow can modify. I use many services and one primary software on my computer. Personally, I use Family Tree Maker because it links with my Ancestry account. However, there are several good programs out there. The advantages of using genealogical software on your computer is that it has additional functionality that the online versions don't provide. No matter what you choose, you can export or import your family tree from one service or software to another using a Gedcom file. What's a Gedcom file, you ask? Glad you asked. It's a file conversion program and an industry standard all rolled into one. It basically matches field for field. So it takes the first name from one program to the first name of the other program, last name from one program to the last name of another program, and so on. It's just equals field for field. So keep in mind that a Gedcom transfer is not a continual link. It is not a cloud service. It is only intended for a one-time only transfer of basic genealogical data from one program to another. So you don't have to retype all of that data when switching from software to software. So that's a brief look at the basic pluses and minuses of charts and forms and how to integrate them into your software that we use today. If you enjoyed this video, please do me a favor and hit the subscribe button below. Give me a thumbs up. Give me some feedback. Let me know what you think. Ring the bell too so that you'll stay on top of the latest videos as they're uploaded. Next up, what is fact from fiction? We'll talk about fact versus evidence versus sources and what's what.